Hello students, we are on chapter 6, the machine stops. We have already discussed the lesson explanation and given the explanation also. So today we shall discuss and I will give the summary of the lesson. Okay. So in this chapter we see that the people are totally involved and depend on the machine, isn't it? So the people are totally involved in the machine and the internet. The world had progressed a lot. All the machine have taken place, the human being activity. So they are busy with their internet and their mobile, and even they don't have time to talk with. That is what we have seen in the lessons. We will see here in the lesson Vasti and Kuno. So who is Vasti? Vasti is Kuno's mother, and both live the post-apocalyptic world. What is the meaning of post-apocalyptic world? That means where humanity lives underground and depend on a machine to provide their needs. So the people live underground and they are fully totally depend upon the machine provide all their needs. So there is no need to do anything. They are the machine is doing everything. So and we see the room, how the room is here. The rooms of the people who live the underground world are interesting. They don't have any light or windows, and yet they are softly lit. There are no openings for ventilation, and yet the air is cool. Anything can be summoned in the room with the help of machine. Music, food, bed, bath, and so on. So anything, whatever they need, we see, you know, in the chapter, just press the button, it is everything is just in front of you. So what provide everything? The machine provides everything. If you want, there is no ventilation or the windows or doors, nothing, but a soft light is there, and also a soft music also is there. And also if you want food, the music, bed, baths, everything is available there. You just press the button. So, Vasti moves around the room on her chair, which is operated by the machine. So, where Vasti sits? Vasti sits on her chair, on an armchair, no? Armchair, and moves around the room on her chair, which is operated by the machine. That is what we see in the lesson. So, Vasti can speak to Kuno for only 5 minutes because she has to prepare for her lesson on music during Australian on the Australian period. Okay, so we see in the chapter the Kuno, the Vasti's son, wanted to speak to her, but she has no time. She can't spend 5 minutes also for her son. She says that I have only 5 minutes. If you want to talk, I can give you, because she is busy with the busy with so many things. And here now she is telling that she is preparing for a lesson on music during the Australian period. And Vasti does not want to travel in the airship. We see that while we read the second part of the lesson, we see that the sun calls her to come to the earth. She says that Vasti does not want to travel in the airship because she dislikes them. She does not like to see the brown earth, the sea and the stars when it is dark. So she dislikes in traveling the airship. Kuno shocks Vasti when he says he wanted to look at the stars from the surface of the earth as his ancestors did 1,000 years ago. So we see in the chapter, Kuno says that he wanted to see the stars like his ancestors did. to go to the earth and see the stars. So it surprised the Vasti. Okay, so Vasti, we can see from this talk that Vasti did not like to go to the earth. And the next one is that being Kuno's mother, Vasti is older than him and more set in her ways. She likes things the way they are, and although she might miss earlier days, she doesn't let it upset her. She is not only in awe of the machine but also respect it like a god. And we see in the lesson also, no, she is the Kuno is asking, machine is not the not god made, it is man made. Kuno, on the other hand, we can see the comparison of Vasti and Kuno, it is speaking about. Kuno, on the other hand, is a thinking man. He is, again, he is able to think and wants to question everything around him, be it the way they live and where they live, to the machine that governs their lives. He is also extremely creative and inquisitive. Okay, so he is very able to think and reason out and ask the questions. So he is not at all comfortable in the machine, we can see. But mother doesn't want to go out of that. So it makes upset whom? The son, Kuno. Okay, so here we see the description of Svadilam. We see in the chapter, what's the meaning of that? Svadilam lump of flesh. That means it indicates the lack of physical activity which gives her unhealthy fleshy look, without little or any little muscles, which gives definition to the body. We see that the body of a Vasti, it is looks very very fair, because the comparison face as white as fungus, it says, no, Vasti's face looks like as white as fungus, indicate that her unhealthy pallor, which is the result of is not getting out of the sun. Why she looks like? Because she is always sitting in the machine, she is not getting out in the sun. That is why she looks like a fungus. And also, Vasti communicate with the people with the help of buttons through the machine. She also communicate, we see in the last part of the lesson, she also communicate with the people with the help of buttons through the machine. They usually communicate about discussing ideas that they have come up with. What discussion they have? The ideas they have come up with, and want suggestion from each other. They take suggestions from each other about the same what other regular thing can be as food and so on. If there is any suggestion, they give the suggestions, and also they communicate with each other, give the discussion, the ideas, and also they give. Okay, all these things we have gone through the chapter. Okay, these are the, and the mission helps Kuno to isolate from the mother. That is what also we see in the chapter. These are the things you have to understand from the lesson. Okay, and also the word meaning which you have to learn from the chapter, page number 86. Isolation. What's the meaning of isolation? Isolation means being or keeping apart from others. Melodious. You can see that the melodious voice in the room. Okay, pleasant sounding. Pleasant sounding. And radiance. Meaning of radiance is soft glowing light. So these are the things you have to go through, children, and learn the word meanings and write down the question answers in your copy and learn the reference, the context also. Thank you, students, for listening.